We are building the first interplanetary ship. Liftoff thrust of this would be about twice that of a Saturn V. I think once we build it, we'll have a point of proof, something that other countries can then go and do. They currently don't think it's possible, so if we show them that it is, they'll up their game and they will build interplanetary transport vehicles as well. The problem with the space shuttle is only a portion of the system came back. The big orange tank, which was also the primary airframe, was discarded every time, and the parts that were reused were incredibly difficult to refurbish. The only kind of reuse that matters is if it's rapid. The only thing you're changing between flights is the propellant. This question of reusability is so fundamental. It costs less to use a giant plane with huge cargo for a long trip than buying a small plane for a short trip. And the same actually is true of rocketry. Once you can get there, the opportunity is immense. Once that has been built and there are means of getting cargo and people to and from Mars as well as to and from the moon, that's really where there's a tremendous amount of entrepreneurial resources that are needed. And that's the equivalent of like the Union Pacific Railroad, because you've got to build out the entire base of industry. Mars will need everything from iron foundries to pizza joints. The goal of this was to inspire you and make you believe again, just as people believed in the Apollo era, that anything's possible.
So you want to wake up in the morning and think the future's going to be great. And that's what being a spacefaring civilization is all about. And I can't think of anything more exciting than going out there and being among the stars.
Everyone in this room is inspired by you. Who are you inspired by?
Well, Kanye West, obviously.